On today's Banker Mashup, we're building an indoor paint booth. So on today's Banker Mashup, we're going to be building a very inexpensive paint booth for inside of our shop. Now this paint booth has a couple of key features. First, it's going to vent all of the fumes outdoors. We're also going to be reusing the inline duct from our resin 3D printer project that we did about a month and a half ago. And if you haven't seen that video, you can look for the card at the top and check out that video as well. Now, before I started working on this project, I had watched a number of different YouTube videos, and there's a lot of different ways that you can build a paint booth. I wanted something that was relatively small and inexpensive, but more importantly, was very effective at moving the fumes outside. And since I'd already put together the 3D resin enclosure, this seemed like this would be a no-brainer to get this put together and be able to have a paint booth inside the shop. Now, I expect this project to go together really quickly. We're only using a few 3D printed parts. We're using cardboard boxes, so I'm actually reusing some of the ones that I've got from shipping product to my house. I've got some foam core, which is really inexpensive. You can get that almost anywhere, and it shouldn't take very long to put this together. So with all that said, let's get to work. There are a few 3D printed parts for this project, and a link for them are in the description. We'll start by tracing this part, and we're just going to draw a circle where we're going to cut out a hole for the vent in the box itself. I'm just using a sharp craft knife here, and this works really well to cut through the cardboard box. Make sure you're careful because this is razor sharp. Turning the box on its side, I'm going to cut the same sized hole through the flap. Next, using a foam core sheet, we're going to cut this to the exact same size as the bottom of the box itself, so we'll have a backing of foam core inside the box. Once you have it cut, place it inside the box, then we're going to turn the box back on its side and cut out the hole inside the foam core. Once we've removed the foam core hole, we're going to test fit our duct to make sure that that lines up. Next, we're going to cut another foam core sheet the exact same size as the last one. This will be used to help direct the airflow to the bottom of our paint booth. Now we're going to apply a little bit of hot glue to our vent, and then we're going to insert it into the box, and that will hold it in place. I did originally put some screw holes in here, but I wasn't able to really make that work very well, so the hot glue option is the approach I took. Now let's insert the foam core sheet into the box, and we'll do that at an angle and mark it with a pen. You can see on the right side there's an open space so air can flow through. Using something sharp like a screwdriver, let's punch a pilot hole for our 3D printed clips that is going to hold the foam core. Now insert the foam core clips into the pilot hole and secure it with the caps on the other side. These should screw together pretty easily. If you find they're tight, you might want to adjust the horizontal expansion when printing them. After installing clips on both sides, we'll slide the foam core into the clips, and this will keep it secured at the top of the paint booth. We repeat the process for the bottom of our paint booth, leaving approximately 40 millimeters or 1.5 inches of space at the bottom so the air can flow underneath. Now we're going to cut the last piece of foam core in the shape of a T, and this is going to be used to slide into the bottom of our paint booth. Be sure to press this in far enough that the top of the T is flush with the flat part of the box. Now let's fold down the top flap and we'll attach it to the foam core using some duct tape. The final step of the booth's construction is to cut off the excess foam core and we'll attach it to the box flaps with some duct tape. All that's left is to install our duct. I start by measuring the window and cutting a board that we're going to mount everything to. This will install inside the window. This mount is for the air output hose. I'm just going to mark this and then cut it out. A few wood screws here will hold everything in place. The blower fan fit perfectly on the board and it keeps everything all nice and neat. After I attach this small piece of hose for the output, all we'll have to do is put this in the window and then we will attach the main hose coming from our enclosure. Attaching the main hose was really easy. These hose clamps work extremely well for creating a good seal so that way all of the smell stays in the tubing and vents outside. I'm really pleased how well this works and hooks into the window. Now that we have our ventilation run, all that's left is to attach the hose to the paint booth itself. Here you can see the smoke being pulled underneath the foam core and vented outdoors. So as you can see, this was a really easy project to put together, and I like this design because it focuses all of the suction for the ventilation to send the fumes outside right at the bottom where we're going to be doing all of our painting. So I think I really like the way that this sucks all the air from the bottom out, and those fumes, as you saw from the smoke test, were going right outside. So I absolutely love this design and I can't wait to start using this paint booth. Now, I also want to give a special shout out to Dano. He was the one that guessed in our patron Discord what we were going to be building with this video. So a special shout out to Dano for guessing that we were going to be building a paint booth. And that is going to be the end of today's video. If you liked it, make sure you mash that like button and don't forget to share and subscribe so you don't miss any of the upcoming videos. Are you going to be building a paint booth or do you already have a paint booth? And how did you build it? I would love to hear about it down in the comments. So with all that said, I want to say thanks again for watching and we'll see you next time.